Gaussian Mixture Model is a probabilistic clustering model that assumes each data point belongs to a Gaussian distribution. Anomaly detection is the process of identifying unusual data points. Gaussian Mixture Model detects outliers by identifying the data points in low-density regions. This is Amy from Grab & Go Info. In this tutorial, we will use Python's sklearn library to implement Gaussian Mixture Model and use it to detect outliers. You will learn how to train a Gaussian mixture model, how to predict anomalies from a Gaussian mixture model using percentage threshold and value threshold separately, how to visualize the anomaly prediction results, how to improve the anomaly prediction performance. Let's get started. Firstly, let's import the Python libraries. We need to import make blobs for synthetic dataset creation, import pandas and numpy for data processing, import matplotlib and seaborn for visualization, and import Gaussian mixture for modeling. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is my most referenced website for data science and machine learning. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me as a content creator and buy me a cup of coffee, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free posts each month for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. In the second step, we will use make blobs from the sklearn library to create a synthetic dataset with outliers. Firstly, we created a dataset with 500 data points, 3 clusters, 2 features, and a cluster standard deviation of 1. Random state ensures the reproducibility of the dataset. Then, an anomaly dataset with 20 records and the cluster standard deviation of 10 is created. The outputs from make blobs are in array format. We converted them into the pandas dataframe format. The dataframe has 3 columns, feature 1, feature 2, and anomaly indicator. Anomaly indicator represents the ground truth of the anomalies, and it has the value 0 for the normal data points and 1 for the anomaly data points. After that, the normal dataset and the anomaly dataset are combined together. In the visualization, the orange dots are the outliers and the blue dots are the normal data points. In the third step, a Gaussian mixture model is trained. Gaussian mixture model is an unsupervised model, and the modeling dataset has features only, so the label anomaly indicator is excluded from the model. After the modeling dataset is created, we initiated the Gaussian mixture model with n components equals 3, and n init equals 5. N components equals 3 means that there are 3 clusters, and n init equals 5 means that the best model from 5 random initial values is selected to build the model. Random state is for the model reproducibility. Then, the Gaussian mixture model is used to fit and predict the modeling dataset X. In step 4, we will use the results from the Gaussian mixture model to predict anomalies based on a percentage threshold. This percentage threshold is usually obtained through historical data or business knowledge. Firstly, the score for each sample is obtained using the score samples method. Secondly, the score is saved as a column in the pandas data frame. After that, we get the score value for the percentage threshold set up for the anomaly detection. In this example, we assume 4% of the data are outliers, and the corresponding score for 4% is -6.56. Finally, a column is created based on the threshold. The data point is predicted to be an outlier if the score is less than the threshold. From the visualization, we can see that the prediction identified most of the outliers, but there are some false positives and false negatives near the clusters. In step 5, we will use the results from the Gaussian mixture model to predict anomalies based on a value threshold. This value threshold is obtained by observing the distribution of the scores. From the visualization, we can see that most of the scores are greater than -5.5, so we set -5.5 as the threshold value. After deciding the threshold score for anomaly predictions, a new column is created to save the prediction results. The visualization shows that most of the outliers are identified correctly, but there are some false positives near clusters. In step 6, we will talk about 2 methods to improve anomaly detection performance. The first method is to improve the Gaussian mixture model performance by hyperparameter tuning. Because the sample scores are calculated based on the Gaussian mixture model, a better model is likely to lead to better scores for anomaly detection. The second method is to optimize the threshold based on the ground truth. Take fraud detection as an example. After identifying the outliers based on a certain threshold, people can look into specific cases and decide if it is a true fraud. If there are a lot of false positives, we can lower the threshold, and if there are a lot of false negatives, we can increase the threshold. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about anomaly detection, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.